sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
Descriptions of fairies. Fairies have many names and descriptions. They usually are invisible save to those with clairvoyant sight. Fairies are elusive, and many prefer to keep to themselves. They can make themselves visible to humans if they so desire. They are best seen at twilight. Some fairies are diminutive, even tiny, while others are huge, larger than humans. Some are beautiful, and some are ugly. Some resemble humans, while others are spirit-like, with wings. William Butler Yeats said of fairies, "Do not think the fairies are always little. Everything is capricious about them, even their size. They seem to take what size or shape pleases them." Traditionally, fairies are feared more than courted. They are supernaturally endowed and can do magic, and for that reason people throughout the ages have sought their help and favors despite the dangers of dealing with them. Some fairies are morally ambivalent, while others are always benevolent, and still others are believed to be always malevolent, such as those that guard places in nature or who like to trick the unwary traveler. Some fairies are solitary, especially those that inhabit the wild. Others live as a fairy race or nation, usually said to be underground and accessed through mounds, caves, burrows, holes in the ground, and under piles of stones and rocks. The land of fairy, also called Elfland, has characteristics of the land of the dead. Time is altered so that a day in human life might stretch into years in fairyland. There is no day or night but a perpetual twilight. The subjective nature of perception of fairies is amply illustrated in the variety of anecdotal accounts recorded for centuries. For example, in 1556, a Dorset, England, man accused of witchcraft, John Walsh, said that fairies were divided into three types: white, green, and black. They could be contacted between the hours of 12 and 1 day and night, but great care had to be taken with the black fairies, for they were the worst. More than a century later, a detailed description of fairies and their realm was written in 1691-92 by Robert Kirk, a Scottish Episcopalian minister who lived near Stirling in the Aberfoyle region. Kirk, a seventh son, may have inherited the gifts of second sight, clairvoyance, and healing from his mother. Kirk's handwritten manuscript, The Secret Commonwealth, still ranks as one of the most significant documents of personal knowledge of fairies. According to lore, Kirk's relationship with fairies was so strong that he did not die physically but passed directly into the fairy realm through a hill at Aberfoyle, now named after him. He remains in fairyland and will help humans who seek him out. According to Kirk, fairies are real and intelligent beings with supernatural powers. He describes some fairies as having light, changeable bodies of congealed air or condensed clouds, while others have grosser bodies and feed on corn, liquor, and grain. Their clothing and manner of speech follow the customs of the land in which they live. Another description of fairies given to Evans Wentz came from a cultured Irish woman, who had frequent visions of fairies and had divided them into five classes. 1. There are the gnomes, who are earth spirits and who seem to be of a sorrowful race. I once saw them distinctly on the side of Ben Bulbin. They had rather round heads and dark thick-set bodies, and in stature were about 2.5 feet. 2. The leprechauns are different, being full of mischief, though they, too, are small. I followed a leprechaun from the town of Wicklow out to the Carrig Sidhe, Rock of the Fairies, a distance of a half a mile or more, where he disappeared. He had a very merry face, and beckoned to me with his finger. 3. A third class are the little people, who, unlike the gnomes and leprechauns, are quite good-looking, and they are very small. 4. The good people are tall, beautiful beings, as tall as ourselves, to judge by those I saw at the Wrath in Rosses Point. 5. The gods are really the Tuatha De Danann, and 98 fairies, they are much taller than our race. There may be many other classes of invisible beings which I do not know. Modern concepts of fairies divide them into 4 main groups aligned with the 4 elements of nature. Earth fairies are associated with gardens, woodlands, nature, flora, animals, minerals, places in nature, mines, caves, and so on. Earth fairies also include those who work in human households, such as brownies, dwarfs, gnomes, elves, pixies, trolls, and knockers are earth-oriented fairies. Water fairies inhabit lakes, rivers, ponds, and other bodies of water, including seas and oceans. Sprites, nymphs, selkies, and mermaids are among the many kinds of water fairies. Air fairies, often called sylphs, govern the winds, the clouds, and the weather. They are especially associated with storms and tempests. Fire fairies live in wildfires, volcanoes, bonfires, the fires of the home hearth, and electricity. It is bad luck to disturb a known fairy dwelling or any place where fairies might live, such as under piles of stone. The fairies will be angry and take revenge. Fairies travel along lines or tracks called fairy paths. The fairies travel along their paths at night at all costs to humans. For example, if someone is unfortunate enough to build a house atop a fairy path, bad luck will follow, for the fairies will march right through it. The occupants will sicken, the animals will die, and the crops will not grow or will become blighted. Doors and windows, especially those right along the path, will not stay closed. In addition to their night marches, fairies move their lodgings on the quarter days, the times of the equinoxes and solstices. They are restless folk and move constantly, until doomsday, according to Kirk. During these mass relocations, people who possess second sight can have terrifying encounters with them. Tradition holds that it is advisable not to travel on those days, and to attend church to pray for protection against fairy attacks. Traditionally, the existence and activities of fairies explain the reasons for illnesses, deformities, and untimely deaths among children, epidemics among livestock, and various disasters of weather. Fairies cause sudden, mysterious, and sometimes fatal illnesses in animals and people by attacking with elf arrows, soft flint barbed arrowheads that are flung with great force like darts.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.